Good morning, children. Welcome to the second session of Chapter 3, Pair of Linear Equation in Two Variables. In the previous session, we have discussed about the general form of a pair of linear equation in two variables, that is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, where A1, A2, B1, B2 and C1, C2 are real numbers such that A1 square plus B1 square not equal to 0, A2 square plus B2 square not equal to 0. And we have discussed a pair of linear equation in two variables can be represented and solved by two methods. One is graphical method and the other one is algebraic method. Now, in today's session, you are going to discuss about graphical method. And we have already studied in 9th standard, the graph of a linear equation in two variables always represented by a straight line. That is, the graph of a pair of linear equation in two variables is represented by two lines. And you will discuss about the conditions for consistency of the equations. If a pair of linear equations is given by a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, then the following situation can arise. In that first one, A1 upon A2 not equal to B1 upon B2. That is, A1 and A2 are the coefficients of X and B1, B2 are the coefficients of variable Y. When A1 upon A2 not equal to B1 upon B2, the pair of linear equation is consistent. That is, when you are drawing the graph of these two equations, you are getting intersecting lines. That means it has only one solution. Now, if A1 upon A2 equal to B1 upon B2 not equal to C1 upon C2, that is, we have already said that A1, A2, that is the coefficient of variable X, B1, B2, coefficient of variable Y, C1 and C2 are constant terms of the given pair of linear equation. If A1 upon A2 equal to B1 upon B2 not equal to C1 upon C2, then the pair of linear equation is inconsistent. That is, the lines formed by the two equations are parallel lines. That means the pair of equation has no solution. Then third condition is, if A1 upon A2 equal to B1 upon B2 equal to C1 upon C2. That is, the pair of linear equation is dependent and consistent. In this case, you are getting coincident lines. That means one line follows on the other and it has infinitely many solutions. We will discuss about the conditions for consistency. If a pair of equations are given, that is a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus C2 equal to 0, you can understand the things better by this table. You have to by heart the table, because sometimes the question comes for consistency or number of solutions. You have to keep in mind what are the conditions or relations between the coefficients of the pair of linear equation. The relationship between coefficients or the pair of equations, that is, The coefficients in the equation are a1, a2 are the coefficient of variable x, b1, b2 are the coefficient of variable y, and c1, c2 are the constant terms. If a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2, then if you are drawing the graph, you are getting an intersecting line. That means the pair of equation has a unique solution, then you can say it as a consistent pair. Now, a1 upon a2 equal to b1 upon b2 not equal to c1 upon c2, then the graph of the pair of equations forms parallel lines, then the number of solutions no solution, and the consistency you can say that the pair of equations are inconsistent. If a1 upon a2 equal to b1 upon b2 equal to c1 upon c2, then the graph of this pair of equation is coincident lines, and the number of solution you are getting infinite solutions, and the consistency of the system is consistent. Moving to exercise 3.2, question number 1, in that second question, 5 pencils and 7 pens together cost rupees 50, whereas 7 pencils and 5 pens together cost rupees 46. Find the cost of one pencil and that of a pen. If the question is not clear, you read one more time and find out which are the unknowns we need to find. Here, we have to find the cost of one pencil and one pen. That means we have to take the variable x as the cost of pencil and variable y as cost of pen. And two conditions are given. Accordingly, you have to frame the equations. So, first step, always write what are the unknowns you have taken. So, let the cost of a pencil equal to rupees x, cost of a pen equal to rupees y, and according to the question it is given 5 pencils and 7 pens together cost rupees 50, that is 5x plus 7y equal to 50. You number it as equation number 1. Second condition is given, 7 pencils and 5 pens cost rupees 46. That is 7x plus 5y equal to 46. Number it as equation number 2. Now you have to draw the graph of these equations. For that, you have to find at least minimum 3 solutions for each equation. For that, from equation 1, we are getting y equal to 50 minus 5x upon 7. So you can substitute any values of x and you will get the value of y. When x equal to 3, you are getting y as 50 minus 5 multiplied by 3 upon 7. That is 50 minus 15 upon 7. That is 35 upon 7. That is y equal to 5. So you are getting the first solution as 3, 5. Now when x is minus 4, you will get y as 10. And when x equal to 5, you will get y as 25 upon 7, that is 3.57. Same way, from equation 2, we have y equal to 46 minus 7x upon 5. You select the values of x in such a way, at least two of the solutions you are getting whole numbers. Then plotting will be easy for you. So you will get the values of x and y as, when x equal to minus 2, you are getting y as 12. When x equal to 3, y is 5. And when x equal to 8, y is minus 2. So you have find 3 solutions for each equation. Now you have to plot the graph of the equation. So you have find out 3 solutions for each equation. Now you have to get a solution of the two equations from the graph. For that, you have to plot the points in the graph paper. For that, the first step is you have to draw the x-axis, that is xx dash, y-axis, yy dash, intersecting at O. Now, you plot the points in the graph paper for the first equation. So, the first value is 3, 5, x coordinate is 3, y coordinate is 5. So, the point is 3, 5. Then, minus 4, 10, x-axis minus 4, and from y you have to take 10, mark the point minus 4, 10, and the third point we find out is 5, 3.6. On the x-axis 5 and y-axis it is 3.6. So after 3, the next dark green line will be 3.5 and the next line is 3.6. After plotting the 3 points, you have to join the 3 points and you are getting a straight line. So the line represents the equation 5x plus 7y equal to 50. Don't forget to write the equation on the line. Same way for the second equation, you have find out 3 solutions. That is, the first one is 3, 5, then 8 minus 2, that is on the x-axis 8 minus 2 on the y-axis. So the point 8 minus 2, and the next is minus 2, 12. X is minus 2, y is 12. So you plot the 3 points, then you have to join it. You are getting a straight line, and the line representing the equation 7x plus 5y equal to 46. Now you can see that the two lines are intersecting at a point. That point x and y coordinate will be the solution for the two equations. Here they are intersecting at 3, 5. Therefore, the x coordinate is 3 and y coordinate is 5. Therefore, x equal to 3 and y equal to 5 is the solution of the pair of equations. The two lines intersect at a point A, 3, 5. So, x equal to 3 and y equal to 5 is the required solution of the pair of linear equation formed. Therefore, cost of one pencil and one pen is rupees 3 and rupees 5. That is, cost of pencil, that is x, that is equal to rupees 3, and cost of pen, that is y, that is equal to rupees 5. Question number 2. On comparing the ratios A1 upon A2, B1 upon B2 and C1 upon C2, find out whether the lines representing the following pairs of linear equations intersect at a point or are parallel or coincident. For that, question number 1, 5x minus 4y plus 8 equal to 0, 7x plus 6y minus 9 equal to 0. Here two equations are given and the two equations are in its standard form. Now you have to find the coefficient of the variables, that is A1, that is the coefficient of variable x, that is 5, B1 coefficient of variable y minus 4, C1 that is the constant term 8. Same way for the second equation, the coefficient of variable x, that is A2, 7, B2, 6, and C2 is minus 9. Now find the ratio for that. A1 upon A2, that is 5 upon 7. Now B1 upon B2, that is minus 4 upon 6. Cut down the common factor, you are getting minus 2 upon 3. Now here you can see that A1 upon A2, that is 5 upon 7, not equal to B1 upon B2, that is minus 2 upon 3. That is, A1 upon A2 not equal to B1 upon B2. Therefore, the given pair of linear equation intersect at a point. Moving to question number 2, 9x plus 3y plus 12 equal to 0, 18x plus 6y plus 24 equal to 0. Since the given equations are in its standard form, you have to write the coefficients, that is A1 equal to 9, B1 equal to 3, C1 equal to 12. Same way from second equation, A2 equal to 18, B2 equal to 6, and C2 equal to 24. Now A1 upon A2 equal to 9 upon 18, that is 1 upon 2. Now B1 upon B2, that is 3 upon 6, that is 1 upon 2. C1 upon C2, that is 12 upon 24, that is also 1 upon 2. So you are getting A1 upon A2 equal to B1 upon B2 equal to C1 upon C2. That is, the given pair of linear equations are coincident. Question number 3. On comparing the ratios A1 upon A2, B1 upon B2 and C1 upon C2, find out whether the following pair of linear equations are consistent or inconsistent. In that question number 2, that is 2x minus 3y equal to 8 and 4x minus 6y equal to 9. Here a pair of equations are given. First, we have to check whether the equations are in its standard form. Here the equations are not in its standard form. So first we have to write it in its standard form, that is, the first equation you can write it as 2x minus 3y minus 8 equal to 0, and the second equation, that is 4x minus 6y minus 9 equal to 0. Now you have to write the coefficients of the first equation, that is A1 coefficient of the variable x, that is 2, B1 coefficient of the variable y, that is minus 3, C1, that is the constant term, that is minus 8. Same way for the second equation, A2, that is the coefficient of variable x, that is 4, B2 coefficient of variable y, that is minus 6, and C2, that is constant term, that is minus 9. Now you have to find the ratio, that is A1 upon A2 equal to A1 is 2 upon A2 is 4. Now by cancelling the common factor, you will get it as 1 upon 2. The same way you find out the ratio B1 upon B2. B1 is minus 3 upon minus 6 B2. That is equal to, by cancelling the common factor, again minus minus getting cancelled, again you are getting it as 1 by 2. Here A1 upon A2 equal to B1 upon B2. So you have to find what is C1 upon C2. C1 upon C2 is minus 8 upon minus 9, that is 8 upon 9. So here A1 upon A2 equal to B1 upon B2 not equal to C1 upon C2. Hence, the given lines are parallel, so the given pair of linear equation has no solution, and therefore it is inconsistent. If you are getting no solution, it is inconsistent. Now moving to question number 3, two equations are given, that is 3 upon 2x plus 5 upon 3y minus 7 equal to 0, 9x minus 10y minus 14 equal to 0. Here the equations are in its standard form. So you can directly write the coefficients, that is a1 is 3 upon 2, b1 equal to 5 upon 3, and c1 constant term, that is minus 7. From the second equation you can write a2 equal to coefficient of variable x, that is 9, b2 equal to minus 10, and c2 constant term, that is minus 14. Now find the ratio, that is a1 upon a2, that is 3 upon 2 upon 9, that is 3 upon 2 multiply by 9. 3 is a common factor, so you are getting it as 1 upon 6. Same way you find out b1 upon b2, that is 5 upon 3 divided by b2 is minus 10, that is 5 upon 3 multiply by minus 10. That is, by cancelling the common factor, 5 is a common factor, so cancel it, you will get it as 1 upon minus 6, that is minus 1 upon 6. Here we can see that a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2. Then no need to find c1 upon c2. That is, a1 upon a2 not equal to b1 upon b2. Hence, the given lines are intersecting. So, the given pair of linear equation has exactly one solution. Therefore, it is consistent. Question number 5. Half the perimeter of a rectangular garden whose length is 4 meter more than its width is 36. Find the dimensions of the garden. It is given, half the perimeter of rectangular garden whose length is 4 more than its width, which means the breadth, is 36 meter. You have to find the dimensions of the garden. Dimensions of the garden means its length and breadth. So the unknowns that we have to find is length and breadth. So first we have to take, let x equal to the length of rectangular garden and breadth of the rectangular garden equal to y meter. And it is given length is 4 more than its width. That is x equal to y plus 4. Number it as equation number 1. So you have got one equation. From the equation you have to find 3 solutions. So from equation 1, you can, since it is a simple equation, you can directly write the table. When y equal to minus 4, x equal to 0. When y equal to 0, x equal to 4. When y equal to 4, x equal to 8. Now the second condition is given, half the perimeter of the rectangular garden is 36 meter. That is half multiply by perimeter of rectangular garden means 2 into L plus B. That is L and B are X and Y. So you can write it as half multiply by 2 multiply by X plus Y equal to 36 meter. That is X plus Y equal to 36. You number it as equation number 2. From this equation also you have to find 3 solutions for drawing the graph of the equation. So from equation 2 we have Y equal to 36 minus X. So find, you can take any values of X and get the value of Y. You will get, when Y equal, X equal to 20, Y equal to 16, and X equal to 16, Y equal to 20, and X equal to 24, then Y equal to 12. You have already find out 3 solutions for both the equations. Now we have to plot the points in the graph paper. So before plotting the points, you have to go through the points. You can see that in both the solutions, we have got the values of x and y as multiples of 4. So you choose a scale on the x and y axis, that is 1 centimeter is 4 unit. Now from equation 1 you find out 3 solutions and you have to plot the points in the graph. Don't forget to mark the x, x dash, x axis, y, y dash, y axis and the intersecting point 0 that you have to mark always. Now for the first equation, the first solution you got it as 0 minus 4, mark the point that is on the y axis. Next point is 4, 0 that is on the x axis and the third point is 8, 4. Now 3 points you have plot, so join the 3 points and draw a line. You are getting a straight line and you have to write the equation on the line, that is x minus y equal to 4, or you can write it as x equal to y plus 4. The same way for the second equation you have find out 3 solutions, so plot the points in the same graph paper. So you are getting the first solution as 20, 16, 16, 20 and 24, 12. So you mark the 3 points and you have to join the 3 points and draw the line. Now you have to find the solution of the 2 equations from the graph. The solution of the equation means where the 2 lines are intersecting. The 2 lines are intersecting at a point C, that is 20, 16, that is x coordinate is 20, y coordinate is 16. So the 2 lines intersect at point C, 20, 16, so x equal to 20 and y equal to 16. Therefore the dimension of the rectangular garden are 20 meter and 16 meter. Question number 7. Draw the graph of the equation x minus y plus 1 equal to 0 and 3x plus 2y minus 12 equal to 0. Determine the coordinates of the vertices of the triangle formed by these lines and the x-axis and shade the triangle. So first part is draw the graph of the equation. Two equations are given. So for drawing the graph from one equation you have to find 3 solutions each. So take the first equation, that is x minus y plus 1 equal to 0. You number the equation as 1. Then from equation 1 we have x equal to y minus 1. You can substitute any values for y. I am substituting y equal to 1, then x becomes 1 minus 1, that is 0. So you are getting the coordinates as, always write x coordinate first, so 0, 1. Now substitute y equal to 3, then you are getting x equal to 3 minus 1, that is 2. So you are getting the coordinate 2, 3. Now y equal to minus 2, then you are getting x equal to, y is minus 2. So write minus 2 minus 1, that is minus 3. So you are getting the coordinate as minus 3 minus 2. Now you have to draw the table and write the values in the tabular column, that is x is 0, y is 1, x 2, y 3 and x minus 3, y minus 2. Same way from equation 2 we are having 3x plus 2y minus 12 equal to 0. From that you can write it as y equal to 12 minus 3x upon 2. Now you have to take the values of x and get the values for y. First we will take when x equal to 0, then y becomes y equal to 12 minus 3 multiplied by 0 upon 2, that is 12 by 2, that is equal to 6. So you are getting the coordinates as 0, 6. Always write x coordinate first. Now when x equal to 2, what value of y you are getting? When x is 2, y equal to 12 minus 3 multiplied by 2, that is 6 upon 2. 12 minus is 6 is 6. 6 upon 2, that is 3. So you are getting the coordinate xy as 2, 3. Now you take x equal to 4. X equal to 4. You are getting y equal to 12 minus 4 threes are 12. So 12 minus 12 upon 2, 0 upon 2, that is 0. So you are getting the solution as x is 4, y is 0. Now you draw a table and plot the points. You are getting x is 0, corresponding y value is 6. X equal to 2, corresponding y is 3, and x equal to 4, corresponding y is 0. We have find out the solution for the two equations. Now we have to plot the points in the graph. For drawing the graph, first you have to draw x, x dash, y, y dash, mark the intersecting point as O. From equation 1, you are having the coordinate 0, 1, that is on the y axis. 2, 3, mark the point, and minus 3, 2, minus 3, minus 2, mark the point, and you have to join the points. You are getting a line and write the equation on the line, that is x minus y plus 1 equal to 0. Same way, from the second equation, we find out three solutions, that is 0, 6, that is on the y axis, 2, 3, mark the point, and 4, 0, that is on the x axis. And join the three points, you are getting a line. It represents the equation 3x plus 2y minus 12 equal to 0. Please don't forget to write the equation on the line. Now you can see that the two lines are intersecting at a point E, that is 2, 3. The question is, you have to find, yeah, shade the triangular part formed by the two lines and the x-axis. So the triangle formed here is EBC. EBC is the triangular region formed by the two lines and the x-axis. So in the graph, the coordinates of the vertices of the triangle ABC formed by this given line and the x-axis are: E has the coordinate 2, 3, B has the coordinate minus 1, 0, and C has the coordinate 4, 0. So that point you have to mark it in the graph also. Moving to homework, the sums that we have discussed in the class, that you have to write it in your notebook, and the questions related to graph, that you have to do it in the graph book. I already told you to buy a graph book of nearly 15 to 20 pages. And the rest of the questions in exercise 3.2, that you have to do it as homework. Thank you.